Ray with Unicorn Riot. We are here at DEFCON 26 in Las Vegas in the DroneWarz Village, which is a new village. Can you guys tell me a little bit about what's going on here?
Today we are hacking drones in here, both from an offensive and defensive perspective. We're hacking the drone license plates at this table over here. So this is proposed regulation for drones to actually have these license plates on them. So we're hacking those as well. We have several commercial drones that will be put in here tomorrow for hacking as well. And we are also building our own payloads.
Currently we're working on a group of wireless and testing tools using a RaspberryPi connected to a drone so that we can actually do flyby testing.
When we started DroneWarz, we actually started volunteering at Roots about 5 years ago. It started as a robotics program first, and then later we became evolved naturally into a drone program as robotics evolved into drones as well. The kids' interest really took off. The Roots program has about 1,000 kids per year that go through it, and so this was a very popular program. Last year, when Homeless joined me, we did a lot more. We built our own payloads for it, which was on a custom operating system that we built over time. And it's designed to be an open source platform that people can build on. The kids loved that. They took Raspberry Pis home at the end of the thing. Everyone built drones throughout the entire workstation. And we had so much positive feedback that DEFCON came up to us and approached us and said, we would really like to see this happen as a full village. Would you please apply next year? We said, absolutely. So we pulled this together. We put together what we thought was going to be a really good, highly interactive, gamified version of drone hacking. And so this is our version one.
So are there any, you said there's some competition going on here. Are there like racing or something else?
Several.
So we do have racing going on. It's all simulated racing for today. Next door, we actually have some of the mini loops to try to fly. If you really want to test your patience, they can be quite squirrely, but it'll actually teach you the basics of how to control a controller. There's also a whole group over here building drones onto clipboards, and people are actually learning how to put a racing drone together. So hopefully we won't see 400 of those in the sky tonight.
So if somebody were interested in drone technology and learning more and they walked in, what happens? Like, is there a mentorship thing going on, or how does that process go?
That's exactly how it happens. So if you look behind the tables, you're going to see that we have some scientists sitting behind the table. So over to my left here, and this is our Pona drone area. And on this section, this is a highly interactive section where we're building the drones that we're going to break.
Yep.
So tomorrow and Sunday, they're all going to be bricks once they're completed. But right now we're building them, getting them ready. And he builds drones for a living, enterprise drones for large companies. He knows drones better than anyone I've met. And he's a fantastic hacker for drones. So we're mentoring people with hacking drones here. And then as you go around the room, each one of those areas has a scientist behind the table that's going to sit there and work with you on your objectives.
Awesome. Do you need to bring anything in here? Computer or?
It's great to have a laptop. You have a laptop to bring with you. Mainly, so some of the stuff like the license plate, RF equipment, if you have it, any software-defined radios, and things like that. So yeah, if you got your bag with you, bring it.
So if somebody isn't at DEFCON, what can they do to start learning this kind of stuff that you can learn in this room? Any resources or?
There's so many. We did put together, we have a website, DroneWarz.org.
Okay.
We are going to be linking a lot of, we've had a lot of great people that have approached us with good research. Some of it's on YouTube, some of it's out there, and we have a lot of collaborators. Annually, our payloads development happens all year round. We're building our own flight controllers, platforms, everything that people will be working with long term, including the CTF events. So we'll be linking more and more content every day, and as more and more collaborators grow, we're hoping that this grassroots initiative literally takes off.
So what do you see for the future? Is there going to be, do you have other ideas brewing for next year or kind of beyond that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Depends on how much space they'll give us.
Yeah?
Yep.
We'll fill it. I can see where you're going with that.
If we can build our ideal flight area, we're looking to build a full active CTF with no rules, with drones that people can bring in, teams of four or eight total in flight, active payloads that are attacking and defending, audience interactive, so everyone in the audience can actually participate and take the drones down too. We're looking for a very highly interactive, large stage to put that on. About 60 by 40 is our ideal space.
Cool. Yeah. Where can we kind of like cast our vote, like give the drone people their space, you know, at DEFCON? So I want to see that personally.
That's a great question.
That is a good question.
Who do I contact?
But I'll say this, the drone enthusiast market is, there's now over a million FAA registered drones in the United States. The largest density of drones that are registered with the FAA is right here in Las Vegas. And so this market is really already a strong market for it. I think DroneWarz and drone hacking and what we're planning on doing with our CTF events presents one of the largest growth opportunities for the DEFCON audience. If you've ever wanted to see it go to three hotels, I think DroneWarz might be the way to do it.
Can you describe in kind of like plain words what a payload is for some of our viewers?
So basically just different sets of tools that we're putting together. Some that can be ran as like a script where it's two or three different tools working together.
Okay.
Some of it on the Raspberry Pi, yes, it's made for Debian, yes, it's made for, you know, it's made for Linux, but it's not necessarily made for the Pi. So we're having to do a lot of stuff and actually pull it together. I've got my youngest mentor back there, or mentee. Actually, I think he's mentoring me this year.
He's pretty sharp.
But yeah, it's getting some of the tools to work together, and that's what we're talking about, an actual payload to put together. And as our drone grows, there's actually going to be a second side of the payloads, which will be physical things that slide on and off of the drone, such as magnets to actually leave devices behind, claw to actually drop USBs behind enemy lines, because why walk in if I can just drop it off? Different things like that. So payloads in down here kind of has a couple of different meanings, but yeah, that's the gist of it.
Cool.
These are operational drones, and although it looks like a weird platform, the idea is that this is a blown apart version of a drone that a hacker can interface with any given component. So if you want to interface with the flight controller itself, you can interface with the flight controller, the receivers, the motors, the controllers. Now this is just a piece we put on for safety purposes.
Okay.
So this lets us know if someone's doing a high voltage attack against the device. It will light up in amber, really bright. So any of us that are standing around the table will be able to tell the attack's taking place. This is our Pona drone objective. We do have these set up for all three protocols for drones.
Okay.
We also have it set up so that you can attack the controllers. We have several different controllers, about eight different options. And again, all for all protocols. And we have it set up so you can attack vision systems. So vision systems would include things like Fat Shark goggles. And Fat Shark's one of our sponsors, so they gave us several goggles to test with, and FPV viewers to attack as well. So those are all within our opponent drone objectives.
Awesome.
We're looking for the best exploits, the best vulnerabilities. Any CVEs that come out of this village, we're one day hoping to rival the IoT village.
Yeah, totally.
Okay.
So there's build a drone, and then this is also part of pwn a drone. Once it's built, we can pwn it, right?
Exactly. Well, it wasn't really intended to have a build a drone. This happened because we ran into a timing issue with the actual conference. We were locked out of our room for a few hours.
Okay.
So we're building now as a group, and that's what's great about DEFCON, because everyone just came in and said, hey, we'd like to solder. Hey, we'd like to go ahead and build. So we built a build the drone station so we could just break what we built.
Very cool.
And we've made a lot of new friends doing it.
Okay.
And we have several commercial drones, racers, different things that people dropped in from the bring your own drone zone section. So there's a lot of different things to play with. DRL and Drone Racing League and MultiGP sponsored a idea of having this group, this community, help find out how they can make races safer. And so the objective isn't necessarily to find out how people cheat or how people can defend against cheaters, but how we can keep a drone from just flying into the audience because somebody had manipulated the systems in air while they were trying to cheat. So that's something we're definitely focusing on from a research perspective. Our second research objective is set around the idea of right-of-way.
Okay.
So drones in the air today are unmanned.
Right.
I have visual systems that I'm using to see what the drone is doing. But if I don't see an approaching aircraft that is manned, or an approaching aircraft that's larger and meets the right-of-way restrictions that you would know that exist in other fields, then I would expect that the drone would have some intelligence of determining its right-of-way path. So we're building the ability to, for an approaching vehicle that should have the right-of-way, to basically push the other vehicle that should not have the right-of-way out of path, so that we hopefully reduce or increase safety to airplanes, or increase fire missions that are being canceled because of drones in flight around wildfires and things like that. So that's something we're trying to do for our community.
Very great.
Yeah.
Awesome. All right. Thanks again.
Thank you.